Hello and welcome back. Please subscribe to support our channel. In this episode, we're going to make the left-hand fuselage side from our mould. Now I realise there's other mould parts to prepare, but it will be nice to see a final part come from our mould and for us to see that it works correctly. And since the last episode, one or two of our club members have been in touch and expressed an interest in also building one of these models. With every part that we produce, the mould becomes more worthwhile. So let's get started.
This is the brand of paste wax that I prefer to use to prevent the parts from sticking to the mould once they're cured. I use a soft supermarket cloth to rub it all over the mould surface, including all the nooks and crannies, and also not forgetting the mould flange surfaces. It then gets buffed to a high gloss and the process repeated in a couple of hours for a total of 5 layers of wax.
All done and buffed up. We're not going to rely on the wax to release the parts from the mould. We're also going to apply a film of PVA release using a dish sponge. Here we go. The PVA release film is now dry and we're ready to prepare for laying up the part. It's important we do this before we mix the resin, even though this has a 1 hour working time, as it's too late when things are sticky and the clock is ticking. We're also going to need 10 or 15 minutes peace and quiet to get the cloth laid down in the mould. Here I've cut the cloth parts out ready in accordance with our template. I've got some gloves, some scissors, a brush, some cleanup materials and our mixing cup.
I weighed all the cloth parts and then made up an equal amount of epoxy laminating resin. Here, I'm gradually wetting out the cloth with a brush. We're doing it one layer at a time and I'm using a brushing and a stippling motion to make sure we remove all the air bubbles.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, the moment of truth. Let's release this part from the mould, if it will. And here we have half a Spitfire fuselage. Now I'm going to have some cleanup to do around the edges, some bits to trim, and then when we join the two fuselage halves, once we've made the rest of the mould of course, then I'll put this back in the mould to join the two halves. But what a great start. Now viewers, it's been a few seconds for you, but for us it's been several days hard work. The left hand side of the fuselage mould worked alright, so I've gone ahead and here I've made the right hand side of the fuselage mould. I've also made the cowling mould, and you can also see that I've joined the mould parts in the same way as we did the first parts of the mould, and I've also filled and sanded them and then primered them, wet sanded them and then waxed them, ready for laying down the PVA release. However, I did learn quite a few things from making the left-hand side of the fuselage from our mould. When I removed our left-hand side out of the mould, I found a few voids caused by air bubbles. And I'm going to eliminate these by changing the patterns
for the material when we cut the parts. So this time we're going to lay the parts up in two phases. First, I'm going to lay down some cloth into these corners with a different type of weave that doesn't move around so much. Once that starts to go green, then we'll lay the remaining parts of cloth using smaller pieces around these highly curved bits of the mould.
Now, here's one I prepared earlier. Trimming the excess fiberglass from the moulded parts using a sharp knife rather than trimming them to shape using a sander saves releasing lots of dangerous fibres into the atmosphere. I wish, however, I'd have done this while the resin was still green rather than fully cured, as it would have made it a bit easier. Wow, that came out nice and easy. Filling these blisters with microblooms and epoxy seems to have worked. Let's finish this fuselage moulding then by joining the two halves using fiberglass bandage. Fastening a brush to a stick will allow us to wet out those hard to reach places. By adding some flock microfibers to thicken the resin, we can lay a bead where it is completely inaccessible between the two halves. We need to let all this set now, so we'll join you again in the next episode where we'll remove the fuselage from the moulds. In the meanwhile, don't forget to check out our channel for other air modelling know-how and related videos. Please like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.